Mr. Roshan Mathias, who will be dwelling more into the maps of the CZMP plans.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are getting into a time where your stomach will start making more noise than your mouth. Okay? But control yourselves, because this is the time you will get to understand what will happen of your village for the rest of the generations that will come in Aldona and in Goa. So this is a very important phase of your life where you have to decide what has to be done and what not has to be done in this village. So, yeah. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Okay. So one thing is. Yeah. This is not a third plan, so I respect whatever decision you all have taken before and whatever plans you have done. But please understand that this draft CZMP first came in 2019. One minute, please listen. One minute, let me finish. The CZMP plan draft was sent in 2019, where all of you all sat, including Komnidad, and made a plan based on that. You all sent it to the government. The government took it and threw it in the dustbin, and they have come with a new plan. Please understand where we are heading. So I'm not saying that your plan is not good or it is very good. It is a good plan you all submitted, but the government disrespected you all and threw it out. So now is a time where you bring in those same objections and put it back in the government. Now, the next thing is when we come and we explain for this program, there could be something new that you may understand which you may have missed. So that is what we are trying to bring before you. One major thing is the major port limits, which definitely now is. Yeah. Sir, my only humble submission is this. First of all, I do not represent the government. I am a person who has a nice house in Kandoli. I can very well be sitting there with my legs on the table and I can enjoy my meal there. But I have come to your village to explain what is good for your village and for the rest of Goa. So don't put me as if I am responsible for the government. What I'm trying to say is, as a subject expert, I will throw some things in light. And if those things are not included in your plan, you have the liberty to do that. These are new plans which the government has sent. That's what we are saying. Why the whole fight is? Okay. 1 minute. Let me handle this. Okay. No. 1 minute. Have you in that plan included your objection for port limits? Okay, 1 minute. Let's take point by point. Port limits are shown in your map. If you want, I will show it to you.
What?
Yeah, so let the group decide to scrap it. No, we are not saying keep the plan. You have not even given us a chance to speak and you're saying we are confusing. I think I would suggest you please sit down, listen to me, listen to what we have to say. If there is anything wrong we have said, we are also open to correction. Okay? Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me once again explain to you about what Captain said about port limits. I hope you have understood. I hope you have understood that there are areas, okay, like yesterday, for example, we were in Mandre, in Oshel. Oh, no, not Oshel, which was the place? Kolwa. Kolwa is not shown on the port limits. So they said, if port limits are not shown, why should we worry about port limits? And that's when we explained to them the Port Limit Act, the Major Ports Authority Act, which has come. That says that they have the right to compulsorily acquire. What is compulsory acquire? Means they have to acquire it without your permission. They will say, this is your compensation, take it and go. That is called compulsory acquisition. So compulsory acquisition of appurtenant land. What is appurtenant land? Appurtenant land means it does not have a definition of how many meters on either side. Appurtenant land means unlimited. So supposing I show the port limit in Mapsa. Supposing I show the port limit in Mapsa. Appurtenant means says that from Mapsa I can come up to even Bicholim. I hope you are understanding. Appurtenant means from, even though it is shown only at Mapsa, I can take land even up to Bicholim. So this is why everybody, whether port limit is shown particularly in your map or not shown, you are affected by it. And this has to be objected. Unfortunately, your map shows port limit, and I will show you that right now on your map. So first, I am showing you something which is called legends. Legend means what is shown in the map. The explanation to that is here in the legend. So on the legend, here you'll see, this is the legends. You have all these different legends. I'll go through these one by one, but first let's handle port limits. Here, the symbol for port limit is this line with the two, like an equal to sign in between. Okay, so you now know how to identify which is port limit. Now this is your Khorjue map. I just took it because it was open. This is your Khorjue river. You seen? Port limits are shown in your river. Now from here, the Major Ports Authority Act says that appurtenant land from the adjacent land of the river. So does your property come in this or no? You are very well affected. And I don't think any one of you are in favor of the port taking your land and you taking some peanut compensation and going God knows where. You have to object this. Put this as a fresh objection in addition to what you all have put. Please add these things, okay? So with port limits, I will come back to this if required, but understand that port limits is to be objected complete Goa. Now let me take you one step further. There are many CZMPs made for the entire country. Gujarat has their own, Maharashtra has their own, Karnataka has their own, Kerala has their own. Each state is making their CZMP. None of those CZMPs have got port limits marked in that. Only Goa government has decided to show port limit in CZMP. The notification of CRZ 2011, on which basis we are doing the CZMP plan, does not mention about any guideline or anywhere that it should show the port limit. The guideline says show the high tide line. Guideline says show topographic plan. Guideline says show the Khazan land. Guideline says shows this, show that, show this. Nowhere it is said they should show port limit. Why is this bulldozed on our CZMP plan is our question. And why it is done? Because, understand this now very clearly. Take it for granted that you and I are already in trouble. Why? Because the act is passed. Whether it shows on the CZMP or it does not show, the act is passed. You are finished. I am finished. But by showing this officially on this map, tomorrow when the time comes to fight, when you stand up there and say, boss, this is my property, this map will be slapped on your face. This is in black and white to even show that appurtenant land and whatever was even marked on your CZMP and it got passed. You got the idea now? This is absolutely disgraceful for our state of Goa to put this, and we have to object it outright. Now I'll move further into other things of your CZMP plan. So the most important thing of a CRZ or a CZMP plan is which area comes under CRZ. Now we had people coming to us and very upset, majhe gaur dakongna. So I also got upset. I said, tujhe gaur khuya. So they brought the plan and this thing and said, epe majhe gaur. You know where the house was? The house was somewhere almost 1 kilometer away from the beach. But she was upset that a house is not shown. So first thing is understand where the CRZ notification applies, where the CRZ rule applies. There are two areas where it can apply. One is a beach side and the other one is a river side. I will not talk much about the beach. I will tell you about the river. Now, when you see a river, there are two edges, am I right? Two edges. For a sea, you have one edge. For river, you have two edges, and you can see that in this map. So, this is... Okay, I'll show you this thing. So, here you see this is the river. This is one edge, this is the other edge, okay? Now, both the edges will show you this pink line, which is called the high tide line. What is the high tide line? High tide line is the line where the water reaches maximum. Some rivers have got a wall at both sides. Some rivers have wall on one side, other side it is open. Some rivers have both sides open, there is mangrove, etc. So wherever the water reaches, that will be called the high tide line. Now in case of a river, there are two high tide lines. So let's take the right high tide line. From the right high tide line, up to 100 meters inside your village will be considered as CRZ area. The same way on the left side, from the high tide line, 100 meters that side will be considered as CRZ area. Anybody coming outside this 100 meters does not come under CRZ rule. And that is why anything outside this need not be shown in this plan. So don't get upset that your house is not there. You should be worried if you come first of all in this 100 meters. Now, sometimes you will find that it is not 100 meters, it is 20 meters or it is 10 meters. The rule says that you have to take the width of the river. So supposing the river is 20 meters, it will be 20 meters this side, 20 meters that side. If it is 80 meters river, it will be how much? 80 this side, 80 that side. But it can go maximum to 100. It can go maximum to 100. Supposing the river is 130 meters, what will be the size? 100, not 130. Maximum is 100. If the river is 250 meters, what will be the CRZ? 100. So maximum it is 100. If it is 90 meters, what it will be? 90 meters. So remember that it will change anywhere from 1 meter till 100 meters. That will be depending on the size of the river. Okay, so some people say, tinga kitle barik dakoela, amka mote dakoela, amka muddam gatle titun. It's not that. You see the size of the river. You understood who comes under CRZ? Only those areas. Now, the next one is, you will see one pink line. This is the high tide line. There will be one more line over here. Actually, honestly speaking, the low tide line is missing in your plan. There should have been a blue line here that is showing the low tide line, but unfortunately they have not shown it. And yes, it's not showing at all in your thing. See, here some places it is shown, the blue line. You can see here, this is the low tide line. On top it is not even showing there. Suddenly it's gone there.
That's the problem with this plan.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. See, here it is not there. So here it should have been shown. So these are things you need to keep adding to your thing, saying it is not shown. Okay, so there has to be a low tide line. Now, as I told you, there will be a 100 meter line or the line of the CRZ, and that is shown here in your map as light green, you know, this line over here. This line is still where the CRZ thing functions, I mean the CRZ rule applies. You will see in this map there is that entire yellow section. Now that section is either CRZ 2 or CRZ 3. What is CRZ 2? What is CRZ 3? CRZ 2 are those areas which are developed. They have lot of infrastructure, they have sewage facilities, they have lot of buildings, lot of people, hospitals, roads, everything is developed. That will be CRZ 2. And anything which is underdeveloped, that is like a rural village, will have CRZ 3. Now, CRZ 2 has its own rules, CRZ 3 has its own rules. But in the case of a river, those rules, basically 100 meters off the river line, is called no development zone. When it comes to the beach area, there is slight difference in CRZ 2 and CRZ 3, but that does not apply for river, and I don't want to get into the beach area. So for the river, that is for all people in Aldana, Korju, and wherever who's affected by this, it is actually a no development zone, means you cannot do any construction or development in this area. Now don't get scared, many people are saying, Maje Gaur already ha, they want to get up and fight. Don't fight, I will come to that, okay, so don't worry. Nothing is going to happen. So this area is considered no development zone. Now you will also find another dotted green dots, like you will find here. See, all this. This is gone even outside the 100 meter line or the width of the river. What are these dots? These dots are when there is a mangrove area. You know what is mangrove, no? That hipli, some in Konkani hipli and something they say for that. If that area of the mangrove is 1,000 square meters and above, then you have a buffer zone for the mangrove of 50 meters. So that mangrove 50 meters buffer zone, that also is considered as a no development area. So you need to check whether they have shown correctly mangroves. There are some places where the khazan lands, mangroves have come and grown by themselves because water has come in, the bandh broke or the sluice gate broken. So if they have marked that as 1,000 meters and above, then your entire village gets affected. Actually, a khazan land is a place where you grow rice. And normally the mangroves are only on the edge of that khazan land. Now, because we are not doing field work there, or because water has come there, we can't do field work, the mangroves are grown. So that is not actually to be shown. You show it at the border of the khazan. Okay, so that will also be another line to see. Now I'll go one by one with what has to be shown in the map as per what they have shown, and you can just note what is shown in your map or not shown, okay? So first thing they show is a lighthouse. I don't know, there's a lighthouse in Aldana, Korje? There is? So please check whether it is marked. It is marked, then fine. If it is not marked, just keep the thing ready with the survey number. There is a lighthouse here, you must say it should be marked. So lighthouse should be marked. Now this is one separate topic which I'll take later about fishing villages, fishing ward, fishing yards, fishing net, whatever, that I'll take later. This will be the symbol for water quality monitoring location. If it is there, please check in your map and either object it. I don't think it will create much of a problem. It's okay if it is there. These multi-purpose cyclone shelters, then you have sluice gates. Now, I don't know where the sluice gates are there in your area. So I'm sure the Komnidad may have already identified the sluice gates, the locations, everything is done. So make sure those sluice gates are shown where the sluice gate is. If it's missing, please add them, or if they are extra, please remove them. The bandh is marked over there. These roads, railway line, and a seawall. So the seawall, many places are not marked. For example, in Kandolim, The entire Aguada Hill has a wall around it. Complete hill is with a wall. But in our map, there is no wall. Okay, so probably some rich guy wants to bring his boat directly up, so they kept the wall not shown there. So we have made sure that they have to put the wall. Then there is the high tide line, low tide line. I showed you in certain places are not featuring. Please make sure. Now, next important thing is this hazard line. Now, the hazard line usually used to mean that wherever the hazard line reaches there will be no development. But now, our government servants went specially to Delhi. They modified the 2011 notification in 2019 and made the amendment and said that that should not apply, but we should only show the line. It will have no effect on any development. So that they have done. Now, what is hazard line? Hazard line means whenever there is a flood, where the water will reach, there the line will be hazard line. Now, this hazard line, some people are arguing, no, why they showed it crooked like this? It should be shown straight. Remember that water will go wherever it can go. You cannot stop water. What can stop water? If there is a sand dune, it will stop the water. If the land is little bit high and sloping, water will not go up. But it will go where there is a field. Where there is no obstruction, there water will go. So the hazard line has been shown in your village. You need to check whether it is shown correctly or not. Okay, just make sure it is not shown over somebody's house or property, which is actually a high area, or you know, there is a mountain and they've shown on that. Yesterday in Kolwa map, I noticed there is a sand dune. What is a sand dune? An area which is little high. On the sand dune, they've shown the hazard line. I mean, then it shows that you are not giving that, characteristic of a sand dune, which is actually to protect the water from coming up. You have shown the hazard line on the sand dune. So you need to check that line and don't get upset because it is coming in the village. It is of utmost importance. Why utmost importance is, I will come to this aspect of disaster management little later, but let's check whether these legends are there in our map or no. So hazard line is there, but needs to be checked. Next one you have is port limit, which we already spoke about. Khazan lands. Khazan land is different from a field. A field is a dry field. Normally no water collects there. But a khazan has a bund. It has a sluice gate. It has water coming in and going out. This is a special field which is low lying and is given the identification of a khazan land. It is different from a regular field. So make sure they are marked as khazan lands. Because there is a special management plan for khazans. There is a special provision which protects khazan land even in the regional plan. So make sure these are marked. You will have special protection for them and you will also have special schemes for khazan lands, etc. Next is boat parking and net mending. This I will come to later because of the fishing thing. Rocks, I don't think you could be having some rocks in the thing. Make sure they are shown. Jetty or shipyard. Now, this is a controversial subject in Aldona. Some are saying there is no jetty coming, some are saying there is jetty coming. If the jetty coming, some are saying it's for tourism, some are saying it is for whatever XYZ reason. Make sure you show the existing jetties, and in case your village wants a jetty for the purpose of fishing or boats or something, you are also allowed to propose. But make sure that no planted jetties are put in your village. That you please remove. You got my point? It is what you want, not what they want. Okay, this whole fight is about they and we. So you make sure that comes. Next is the fishing ward boundary. Again, something to do with fishing, which I'll come to. Fish breeding areas, again I'll come to. Fishermen community complex, water body. Now, about water bodies. I'll just show you this because you're looking and you're wondering what I didn't show you. This is about high tide line of Kandolim. They had shown the high tide line pretty low. And then we have put in proof of, this is 2019 where the water had come right inside the shacks. You remember it had come all over the news and everything. So we said if water came in the shacks, that has to be the high tide line. So we have given our own thing like that. in Kandoli. I'm just saying, see how the government works this plan, and they try to run with the public hearing so you don't notice these things. Now, you tell me, a very normal person in the world will tell you this answer. Every year, does the water come up or it's going down? Comes up, you're sure? So if the water comes up, the high tide line will come higher or it will go lower? Higher. Now this is Kandolim. This side is the beach, this side is the village, and here is the 500 meter line. Okay? This is the plan of 2019 which they had sent. The 500 line you'll see is almost on the border of this survey number 51. So now when they send 21, where the line should be, here or here? This side, right? Here somewhere. But you see, some MLA's property or some Delhi fellow must be coming in CRZ line. So he has gone and made his presentation and the line is now come down. And like that, right from Kandolim top till down, it is totally shifted to the left. Many properties have come outside the CRZ. And this is in a time when water is rising every year, our high tide line is going lower. So you see the interference of politics and the masti they do with our plans. Okay, so this you need to check in Aldona. I don't think you are that receptive to all these Delhi guys and stuff like that. Yeah. Yeah, sir. I would suggest let's finish. Yeah. No problem. Yeah. Yes. It is. Yes. So I'll come to this controversial subject about structures. Everybody wants their structure to be shown. This is a basic fact. Everybody wants their structure to be shown only for one reason: to prove to the world that my house is legal. Am I right or wrong? Now, first of all, this map, CZMP, has got nothing to do whether your house is legal or illegal. What the CZMP plan is doing, it is simply telling you where is the high tide line, where is the 100 meter line, what is that zone, where is the khazan land, where is this, where is the lighthouse, where is this, where is that. It has got nothing to do with your structures. You got this right? That's why don't get scared that because it is shown here or not shown here, it is going to be broken or somebody is going to do something. It is not. Okay? Now, the structures. The only place that something is written about structures in the notification is this. Annexure 1, subsection 2, 13 clearly indicates that the existing authorized developments on the seaward side shall be clearly demarcated. First of all, this is not meant for the rivers. This is meant for seaward side. And that is why, because as per CRZ 2, you can build up to 50 meters from the high tide line, but there should be an existing authorized structure, and from that level onwards you can build, not beyond that. And so this rule was put because of them. You identify which structures are authorized and then permissions can be given. But in the case of a river which comes to y'all, there can be no permissions given anyways. So there is no question about existing authorized structures even being shown for Aldona, Khorjo, etc. It's mainly for beach areas. So what our suggestion is, and we have made this to the government, is that first and foremost, remove all the structures which are shown in the map. Don't get angry with me, I will explain. Some structures are showing, some are not showing. Have you noticed this in your map? I don't think you all went to see. You all are good people. We went and searched whether our houses are there or no, and we created a commotion. Now, which houses came? When this map was being made, the Land Survey Department of Goa gave the 71 or 70 something it is, that plan they gave the NCSCM. So whichever houses were showing of that time have come in the map, the recent ones are not showing. So those people actually have taken that map to show the survey borders and not the houses. But since the houses came along with the map, they put that also here. But now you see the cunning part of it, and I'll explain to you, giving example of my own house and another place in Kandoli. My house is built before 1990, which was before CRZ. I have got all the possible documentation, licenses, everything. My house is not showing. I am within the 500 meter zone. But there is this structure of a club which is running in Kandoli, on which we had filed a case in 2018. The CRZ department said demolish it, it is illegal. They went to the High Court. High Court said demolish it, it is illegal. They went to NGT in Delhi. NGT said demolish it, it is illegal. They went to Supreme Court. The Supreme Court said don't even bring this here. We honor the report of the NGT, and so don't bring this here, demolish it. And this last order which came was in February 21. So right from 2018, all these courts they ran, and finally Supreme Court in February said demolish it. Till today it is there. And that structure is showing in the CZMP and not our house. How these things happen? You and I are happily writing objection and suggestion. You are not going with a suitcase there in the office and saying put my house there. You understood what's happening in our offices? This is exactly what is happening. High tide lines change, houses come over there, amendments are done to the act just because it suits what they want. This plan is for them, not for us. It says don't show port limits, or rather does not say anything about port limits. That is again put in this plan. What they want is put in this plan. So like these, the structures, we are saying remove all structures. Now when the structures will come, is on 11th March, just 2 days back. Today's 14th, so 3 days back. The government has come with a notification, gazetted notification, to say that they have constituted a committee, Fishermen's Planning Committee. And it has got a lot of members. I'll even show it to you, 1 minute. This is the one on 11th March 2021, this gazette notification. And this says that they will constitute a subcommittee with employees of the fisheries department and representative of fishing community at taluka level to assist the fishery planning committee. So this committee has been formed. It has all these people on it. See, this is from Barde, some five people, four are there. Their phone numbers are also given, their name, and for which area they will be taking under. So I don't know if your Aldana will come. No, I think this shows this. So these people are in charge for Bardes, these four. Then Tiswadi has its own people, and Kankona, all these people. So what is their job? So their job is here written on that side. The committee will undertake ground level survey for completing the following task. What is the task? Identification and demarcation of local community houses within 100 to 200 meters, this is of the sea. Identification and demarcation of fishermen houses, this they will be doing. Identification and demarcation of existing fishermen infrastructure. So that is where I brushed through earlier, those fish mending areas, boat keeping areas, ice factories for fishermen, or net mending areas, all these will be identified. And requirement of new infrastructure for fishing activity and other allied pertain to fishing community. So basically these people will be coming and doing a survey for all these houses belonging to fishermen. Now, we are also asking in our objection and suggestion that a complete survey be done of all the existing structures within this CRZ areas. And they have done this in 2006. So if you see on the GCZMA site, there is a map called Goa Structures Map. And in that map, up to 2006, even though they were built after 91, all structures have been identified and surveyed to such a limit. I will show you that. Yeah, this is called Goa Structures Map. So it has got all these villages under that. I think they have not covered the river side. So that is what we are insisting now. When they have done this, for example, this is now which place? This is Keri village. So they have gone and checked all the structures which come within the CRZ up to the 500 line. Okay? And you see they have got color codes. So the house, the structure has got some color codes. Now what are these color codes? Dark green means structures as on 23rd March 91. Then which is light green is 1991 structures extended after 23rd March. So like that in detail, which came up between 91 and 93. Purple is which came from 94 to 98. Orange is which came up in 99. Green, this other green is which has come from 99 to 2002. So like this, they have already done up to 2006 of the sea coast. So what we are saying is, you do this same thing again up to 2021, also for the river sides, that is including Anjur, I mean Aldona and all these areas. And after this is done, then you include that in a CZMP or a land use map of the CRZ area. Do you agree with this? Because what is happening, if we don't do this survey, people like that Toy Beach Club are coming there, Delhi Fellows houses are coming amongst us, our houses which are legal are not coming, fishermen's houses are not coming in that, and this is absolutely injustice to the people of Goa. So we are saying now make it a clean slate, do your survey properly, you see what is legal, illegal, you do all those things, and then you show the structures on the map. The second option which we are giving the government is, you show all the structures, whether legal or illegal. And if you've seen, if any one of you has taken a copy of a new survey plan from the department, you will see on top in red they have written, all structures shown in this plan need not conform to their legality. You have read this line on top? That means whatever structures are showing need not be legal or legal, it is not conforming that. But it is shown. So you either show all the structures and put that caption in the map, or you remove all structures and put them after you have done your survey. Okay, so this is what we are talking about, structures. Regarding structures, you have any query, then you ask me now, because then we'll shift to the next thing. Yeah. I would suggest, please, I would say let's talk about Aldona, because I have a lot to speak about Kandolim and we won't have time. It is a fact, I'm not saying no. But Kandolim has its structure map already. And my house is showing there. Before 90. Anything about structures? Yes. Sir, if we can remain with topic. Thank you. Okay, so I'll go ahead. Now, what is important next is for you to see structures of archaeological importance and heritage site. I'm sure Aldona and etc. have got old houses, temples, crosses. If these are within the CRZ limit and have not been shown, please identify. Give the correct survey number and present it before the GCZMA, say this is existing there. Okay, yesterday we did Oshel and there was one entire temple which was missing. So we've given that survey number with the photograph, everything we've given. So make sure this is there. The next important thing, maybe not very interesting for Aldona, but important. The rule says that, this is the notification says that, dressing or altering of sand dunes, hills, natural features including landscape changes for beautification, recreation and other purposes. What it says that these are prohibited activities. Means you can't do these things. What you can't do? You can't dress or alter a sand dune. So that means even people from Aldona, when you come to Kandolim, don't touch the sand dunes. Okay? Hills, if there are any hills, you can't be touching that. Natural features like water bodies or forests or any of these natural features, you can't use this even for landscape changes. Forget building something, you can't even do landscape, or even beautification cannot be done on these. Now my question is, when somebody wants a permission to build a house in CRZ, this is Kandolim map. I'm just showing you this for example. You know which area this is? Shikerim Hill. Okay, this is the river going to Mandovi inside. This is the Arabian Sea. Now say I want to build my house here. This is my property. I want to build a house. What actually this is? Is it a hill? You all don't know Shikeri? This is a hill or no? This is a hill. But when the person in the office is sitting to give the license and I go and I show my property here, you'll say, ah, okay, it is coming in that area above the 100 meter line, I'll take the license. How will he tell you that this is a hill or no? Or how will he tell you that it's a low-lying field or no? It is not marked, it is simply marked as CRZ area. So what we are saying is, and what the act, I mean the notification says is, it says that topography maps are to be used as base maps. What is topographic map? It's a colorful map. So where the water level is, it will show blue color. Then when it goes little higher and higher, it starts becoming yellow to green to yellow to orange and to red. What is red? The highest peak, like the tall mountains, will show red. Then you know it comes. So when you have that kind of a color in Shikeri, it would show blue coming to red. When you say red, you say, "Arey, it's a hill. You cannot do development there. Sorry, thank you very much." But it has to be done that way. Showing these plain level base maps will not do. We are insisting that a topographic map be done, and this would be requested to do also for Aldana, so that your areas, your natural beauty that you have of this is not tampered with. Okay, so please make sure that comes.
Do you have a map for Aldana?
Yes, it's there, sir. I showed you. I don't know who's saying something. Yes, sir. The digital copy? Yes. Yes, we have the maps of Aldana, sir. I'm explaining to you the features first, then you'll have to go in detailing. Okay, I'll come back to Aldana. In Aldana, you will have to mark the Khazan lands. These come under CRZ 5 areas. Okay? So this is your Khorjaim Aldana map. And the areas have been marked here. But you need to see these blue and white lines refer to Khazan lands. You need to see whether it is correctly marked. Okay, this year, definitely your Komninath will be able to help you to understand the Khazan lands. And along the Khazan lands, make sure the bandh is shown properly and also the sluice gates. Okay, so this is with Khazan lands. Next thing is, you will notice that in all the village maps, no water bodies are shown. So sometimes in between a Khazan land, you will be having something called a poi, which is not the river, but it is the water area behind the bandh or along the bandh. That has not been shown. So those points need to be marked as water bodies. Okay, they cannot be considered a Khazan land, they are water bodies, so it has to be shown. Also Toi, you know, they have lakes or ponds. These are not shown, so please make sure they are shown. Another feature about water body is, the notification says it has to be clearly demarcated if the water body is a sea, lagoon, backwater, creek, bay or estuary. So when they've written this Khorjaim, they have to write whether it's a river or it's a backwater or what, because according to that, there are rules that have to be applied. And this is a problem everywhere. I mean, then we fight saying it is a bay, and some are saying it's a beach, some are saying it is the sea. So that has to be clearly marked. The second thing is indicating the pollution levels. Now this is very important. The pollution board of, what's that? Pollution Control Board of Goa, they have already done a study of the pollution levels of all the rivers of Goa, and they have reports for each river that's available online. Now the notification says it has to show, but if you see your map, nowhere it has shown the level of pollution in your river. And why this is important is when you see Aldona map, you're only seeing Aldona map. One day this map will be attached to all the other maps of Goa. It will show a Goa map. All maps of India will be then joined together. It will show a India coastal map. That will be joined to other country maps. It will show a whole world coastal zone map. Now this is being monitored by the World Bank and other organizations who are helping in maintaining this coastal area. So what they will do is, when they see Aldona River is so dirty, they will talk to our government and say, we are offering our help and this is the amount of money we are sanctioning for your area, clean up that water. So this is why it is important to show those levels, because if you don't show it is dirty, you will not end up getting that attention from the World Bank and you will not be getting the right remedy for the thing. Yes, sir. Pardon?
So many, so much talk coming about coal coming in, jetties coming. Can you identify the same region? You have a sentiment.
There are jetties shown. No, I can't, there is no jetty shown as of now. Okay. So next. So remember the pollution levels. Now last thing is port limits, we've already spoken. In none of your rivers, nowhere in Goa, have they shown fishing zones. The notification says the fishing zones in the water bodies and the fish breeding areas shall be clearly marked. Okay? You see our Aldona River. So, as for what I know, is when human beings have to stay in a house, we know which is a bedroom, we know which is a hall, we know where is the kitchen. Does a fish know which is his bedroom and which is the kitchen? But if you see here, they have marked fishing breeding areas, fish breeding areas in only one section. It looks like when they want to breed, they will go only there and breed. Actually, the whole river or wherever mangroves are there, it should be shown as fish breeding areas. Okay, the second thing is, now in this entire river of Aldona, you will find there are port limits shown, but there is no fishing zone. Actually, in this river, lot of our fishermen are going and putting nets. There is not one place where there is a fishing zone shown. So this has to be brought up by your objections and suggestions to put the fishing zone. and remove the port limits from here. Okay? I think if you have bird nesting areas, please make sure they are put. If you have mud flats, please put these. I think what you do is, after this, you sit with your people and you see that all those things are there. Correct. That's what we just said. That's what we just said. One thing, do you all have mud flats in your areas? No, mud flats. Yeah. Correct. Have you all identified? Yes, it's there. Correct. Nesting areas.
Alden, thank you very much. I'll tell you what. Right now, we are having a plan which has been put up by the government, which we are fighting with the government. Let me finish. We are not fighting with the people. We are fighting with the government. Please understand this. Number two is, the comunidades are very, very vital parts in the institution in the village. I recognize I'm a shareholder of comunidad, and I know they are virtually local self-institutions, and they have to be recognized. You all have done tremendous work. I know you all have set, you all have presented it. But remember, this is a new plan submitted in 2021. All the previous objections, we will include them. Please have patience. He is only explaining to us. He is not our enemy. He's not an official of the government. He's helping us to understand it so that we can raise the objections. Please understand. Otherwise, there will be no point. They are come to help us, we are attacking them, and this is not going to be very good for us. Tomorrow is the last day to submit the objections. We will take the time for suggestions after he presents. After he presents, there will be time for suggestions. Exactly. We'll do it. Don't interrupt. Let him explain. So even I don't know the technical parts. The government has given the plan in January and asked us to give in 30th January. They put up the plan and asked us to submit the thing by tomorrow. That is the only reason we have to object. We have no other reason. Right.
You were present for the last one.
Yes. We took the resolution. Do you believe the resolution has gone to the government?
I do not give a shit if it has gone to the government. Why did you not show this stuff there?
We didn't have the plan. The panchayat didn't show us the plan. That is the reason we took the resolution. We have not been shown the plan. No way.
You take the judgment for the argument?
Of course, we have to be ready.
When you go to court, do you take the judgment before the argument?
See, Mr. Shagas, I will tell you one thing. If we don't have the plan, we reject it in the Gram Sabha. That is what I did. What did we do in the Gram Sabha? We rejected it. We rejected it because there was no plan put to the people.
You didn't show the people this.
How can I show the plan?
Then you should not have asked for the resolution.
You could have objected to it.
You know it as much. You are an advocate.
You are looking
up. Why did you not? I should have objected.
We have come for the benefit of the village. We have not come for any of this thing. So all of us spoke for it. All of us spoke for it. Exactly. Correct.
I'll give the last point, Jatin. I'll give the last point and finish it.
We can't hear. Can you come? Can you hear? Can't hear. Correct. Correct. We don't know the facts. Correct. Yeah. Correct. That's he will show. I'm not technical expert on the maps. That's why they are there.
Sir, you are not a technical expert about the maps. On that particular day, the Gram Sabha, what authority did you ask this objective without any discussion, without any knowledge for the Gram Sabha? We are the Gram Sabha. We should know.
Spoken in the Gram Sabha on the legal aspect that the plans were not put, please let me finish, you spoke that the plans were not put to the public, we had no knowledge, you can't hijack these plans and get them approved behind our back. The Gram Sabha requires to prepare the plans and we have to submit it. This was the resolution, we have taken it. I have not spoken whether anything in the plan is right or wrong. Please understand, I spoke on the legal aspect.
Carlos, I think leave his personal questions aside. We'll finish our program.
This time, looking after the welfare of our village, you should have been the first one to get this to the rest of the village. We could take an informed decision.
How could I? How can I even hijack when the panchayat has not done it? When the panchayat has not done, that is why we came up to inform the Gram Sabha that the panchayat has defaulted.
In that case,
then we would have not objected to the plan. But then we would not have objected. There would have been no objection from us. There is. I have only spoken on the legal. There is no way.
I think I will just finish my last part of the thing because we've got two more awareness programs to be done. We have to move to the south right now. My last point is, this plan is very important with regards to disaster management. Okay, if you remember last year or the year before last, the dams were open, the Tilari dams I think were open, and there was a huge flood in Kamurlim, you remember? And the water reached into people's houses. And it was very sad to see that there was no disaster management plan in place. And the boats had to come, go to the houses, give food. So this is one of the aspects that need to come in your CRZ plan. And for that to be fruitful, you need to see that all the roads are shown. Now you will see in these maps that all the roads are not shown. Each and every road has to be shown. Each and every hospital, each and every public place, like if you remember Captain said, when they were stranded due to the tsunami, they were all kept on a football ground. But in this plan, you show me where is the football ground? It is not marked. Where is a hospital marked? It is not marked. Where is the panchayat ghar marked? It is not marked. These are the areas where you will be taken to when the flood happens and you will be given food or medicine or shelter, whatever, in these areas. So this has to be marked in your plan. So make sure you go through that and you mark all of this. I think that comes to an end with my CZMP presentation. If you have any questions, please ask. Otherwise, we have Bab Swapnesh Sherlekar who will speak for some time. That is the contour map for the purpose of hazard line. Yes, so that's why we are saying if they show topographic map should be enough, but if they give a contour one, it is even an added advantage. Yes, and in our, if you see our objection, I'll show you.
The second point is, are you looking at this CRZ?
Are?
Going.
Okay, with regards to Poi and Khazan land, the original notification of 2011 said that wherever salt water with 0.5 ppt reaches and that area has a tidal influence, that means it has a high tide and low tide, those areas will be marked as the high tide line. And officially or technically, the Khazan lands are that. The water that comes in a Khazan land is salty. The Khazan land water which comes is affected by a tidal influence. But what happened was, in certain areas, there were minister properties which were coming under influence of this CRZ line because the line was going from the bandh right into the Khazan land. So the lands there were getting affected. So what these people do, are you aware that there is already a 2019 notification? We have a 91 notification. Now what we are dealing with is with 2011. There is already a 2019 which is not applicable to us because our homework of 2011 is not submitted. The moment this submits, 2019 come. But our MLAs, our minister, goes right up to Delhi and he amends the 2011 notification in 2019. He goes and he does this. Just because some ministers' properties are getting affected. But how many MLAs went for the fishermen community and amended the rules? How many people went and amended the rules for the fishermen zones and the sport limits? Nobody. So they amended the petition and they said the high tide line will not be calculated at the end of the Khazan land. It will be restricted up to the bandh and the sluice gates. So now what we are saying is, you restrict the high tide line at the sluice gate and the bandh, that's fine. But don't ignore the fact that there is a water body which is a Poi and which needs to be shown. Because you are showing a Khazan land by marking it which is after the CRZ line. So you also mark the water bodies which are there after the CRZ line which are coming within the Khazans. So that will protect your Poi and your Toi and all those ponds, etc. Okay?